In this video tutorial, I'm going to review how to add and subtract polynomials. So this is the general form on how these problems are presented. The first thing I look at is there anything out front of each parentheses that we're multiplying through? So this one, even though it looks like there's nothing there, it's just the number 1 there. So if you multiply the 1 by anything, you're going to get the exact same thing. So we're still going to have 8x to the 4th plus 2x squared minus 1. On this back parentheses, pay very close attention to what operation wants. It wants you to add these two. And I would pay attention to see, is there anything that needs to be multiplied here? There's nothing, so this is all going to stay the same here because it's just a positive 1 there. So we're still going to have a plus 3x cubed minus 5x squared plus 7x plus 1. Now, once I figure out all those pieces, all we have to do is combine like terms. And now with polynomials, what we're looking for is we're looking for terms that have the same variable and the variables to the same power. For example, I have an 8x to the 4th here. And if I look through, I have no other 8x or x to the 4th, I mean. So my first term is 8x to the 4th. I start with the highest power there. Then if I keep looking through, I see I have a plus 3x cubed, so my next term is going to be plus 3x cubed. Now I'm going to go to my x squareds, so I have a 2x squared and a minus 5x squared. 2 minus 5, I get negative 3x squared. After x squareds, I go to just plain old x's. I got this 7x here, so I'm going to add 7x. And then last, I go to my constant, my numbers, my terms without variables. So I have a negative 1 plus 1, which is 0. I'm not going to put the plus 0, so I end up with that as my solution. And this is in standard form because it goes from the highest power all the way down to the lowest power. All right, let's do a subtraction problem. Very, very similar. I first check and see, is there anything multiplied out from this parentheses? No. And then I look at my second parentheses. I'm going to have to do a little bit of work on this one. Pay attention to the sign in the middle. They want us to subtract these two. That's going to be like having a negative 1 there. And I'll get to that here in a second. So this front one, we're not going to change at all. So we still have 3x cubed plus 8x squared minus 4. The second polynomial here, what we're going to do is we're going to take this negative 1, and it applies to everything in this parentheses. So I'm going to distribute it to every single term in that polynomial. So I have a negative times a positive 5x cubed. That's a negative 5x cubed. A negative times a negative x squared is a positive x squared. A negative times a negative x is positive x. And a negative times a 17 is minus 17. Once you distribute, it's going to be very similar to the problem we did earlier, just combining like terms. So I'm going to start with, let's see, the highest power is my x cubes. So I have a 3x cubed minus 5x cubed. It's going to give me negative 2x cubed. Go to my x squareds, I have 8x squared. And this, that's a 1x squared, even though it looked like there's no number there. 8x squared plus 1x squared is 9x squared. Then go to my x's, I just have this plain old plus x, so I'm going to have a plus x. And then I have minus 4, or a negative 4, minus 17, and that will give you negative 21. It is also in standard form, goes to the highest power of x, all the way down to my lowest, which is the constant. So that would be adding and subtracting polynomials. Key thing there is, pay close attention to the sign in the middle so you know if you're adding, subtracting, and then later on we'll see multiplying. And then with subtraction, there's a little bit of work you have to do. You have to distribute the negative sign. That's it.